once again, welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews. We've got Hurdy Gurdy Mushroom Man. Hurdy Gurdy Mushroom Man. We've got Hurdy Gurdy. Another one, I think they've got a few beers on the Green Kings that are kind of tributes to different music, different kind of music. I think Hurdy Gurdy was a Donovan number, if I remember rightly, something like that. Hurdy Gurdy Mushroom Man. You got a Beatles one as well, which is the Revolver. So they've got a few that are harking to different musics and that. I've had a smell of this and it smells fantastic. When you're tasting thousands of different beers, you don't get tired, but you never get tired with beers, but you get kind of where you're going, oh, it's another grapefruit, oh, it's another grapefruit, oh, it's another citron, and things like that, you know. When you get something that's different, you go, whoa, and everything goes out. And you get excited, and sometimes it's very challenging, because you kind of go, I don't know how to explain it, which is good for us guys, because it gets the juices flowing. Let's go for it, let's have a sniff. Like I say, hurdy-gurdy, and we're talking 4.1% ABV, so it's kind of low session. So let's have a little sniff. Ah, oh, it smells lovely. We got tiny little nettle background notes, little kind of nettle grassy background notes. We got banana, kind of like a flambé banana, something like that, like plantain, when you get plantain in the kind of West Indian mills in it. It kind of, it's like estuary, it's like as if it's been hot brewed. Kind of hot brewed sort of smell to it when they get them esters coming up. And then some nice little gentle notes, little gentle kind of hops in the background. Beautiful malty taste, smells on the nose anyway, on the bugle. Lovely little malty notes on the bugle. Kind of Horlicks notes on the bugle, really nice. Those parallel malts, nice little Horlicks-y. Kind of almost cooked wheat bit smell. Let's have a go. Cheers. That is weird, wonderful, and beautiful. That is lovely, but it's so weird. That is, do you know what? Hurdy Gurdy is probably the best name for it because it is weird, really weird. But it's really lovely. Try it out. If you're kind of tasting a lot of beers, you've got to try it out. There's a slight little sherbet background there. There's kind of little, almost gingery notes in the background. Weird little notes, almost little coriander, and there's certainly wheat in there. You've got the smoothness of wheat, little kind of wheaty, bready sort of background notes. That's lovely. That is lovely. I don't think I've had a bad beer off these boys yet. Like I say, I've never been keen on the bottled plain IPAs and that, but everything else by them is lovely, extraordinary. And this is a lovely, lovely, lovely beer. Get yourselves down here. If you're coming down to the GBBF, get down here early, run down to this stall and get a 5X because they sell out so quick. I've seen so many people coming up and going, have you got a 5X? And they're all going, nah, I've got one. So if you didn't get a 5X, but that is lovely, try that out. Little marshmallowy notes, almost kind of when you get the rye and things, you get kind of crystal rye or something, you get like little marshmallowy, nice sweet little notes in there. There's that in there as well. That is lovely, that really is nice. Cheers everyone, bubbles up, chin chin, and I will see you in the next one. Don't be late. We'll start with that, honestly. That's easy drinking. And I've got someone holding their hand out to me.
Cheers, <laughs> Cheers.